More towns in Iraq have now fallen to this heavily armed ISIS group. They have taken control of more real estate and are now getting awfully close to the border with Jordan and Saudi Arabia. That will get the region's attention very quickly, just as it has the attention of the U.S. Secretary of State. John Kerry has made a rare visit to Baghdad, delivering a very blunt and sobering message that President Obama could launch a military strike at any time. Our chief foreign affairs correspondent, Andrea Mitchell, is traveling with the secretary with us tonight from nearby Amman, Jordan. And Andrea, it is notable that 11 years after this U.S. invasion of Iraq that was meant to make that country safe for democracy, the U.S. Secretary of State still has to come and go secretly and under heavy security.
Indeed, and it's his first trip there in more than a year. Ryan, John Kerry's message, his urgent message today to Baghdad's political leaders was stop fighting amongst yourselves or else risk having ISIS shatter Iraq's fragile peace.
Iraqi troops didn't turn and run today, but ISIS militants still advanced to Bakuba, less than 40 miles from Baghdad. The insurgents and their allies now control almost the entire border with Syria, and for a while also seized a key checkpoint with Jordan. Adding to the urgency of John Kerry's trip to Baghdad, landing at the embassy by helicopter under intense security. He met with Sunni and Shia power brokers, but for almost 2 hours with Prime Minister Maliki, stressing that this is a moment of decision, a critical time for Iraq's leaders.
Iraq faces an existential threat, and Iraq's leaders have to meet that threat with the incredible urgency that it demands. The very future of Iraq depends on choices that will be made in the next days and weeks.
Did the other leaders with whom you met today indicate that they have the confidence that Prime Minister Maliki can change?
All of the leaders that I talked with today, including Prime Minister Maliki, professed their commitment to meeting the date and their understanding that they need to move rapidly to form a government.
Nothing illustrates how much things have changed here in Iraq than this U.S. embassy here in Baghdad, the most fortified, the largest embassy in the world. Yet now thousands of its staff have been redeployed, have been relocated to safer posts because of the threat of ISIS.
And as ISIS grabs more territory, Shiite militias backed by Iran organized to fight back. The threat of civil war is real. And with militants now controlling Iraq's border with Syria and threatening Jordan, the U.S. is not going to wait forever for Maliki to show he can lead.
Kerry also said pointedly today that the U.S. is gathering critical intelligence that President Obama is ready to take military action. If it becomes important, he will do so. And also today, Iraq finally granted U.S. troops legal protection that the U.S. has been demanding. And those first U.S. military advisors will be embedding with Iraqi forces, with the Iraqi command in the next few days, Brian.
Andrew Mitchell covering the travels of the U.S. Secretary of State, starting us off from Amman, Jordan tonight. Andrea, thanks.